Leeds. It's so scary that I'm having to stand here for our right to continue to have a voice in a country where we work, we pay taxes in, and we bring up families in. But I was left with no choice. It's also great to see so many organisations here to stand together, because without the right to protest, to exact change, none of us would have the rights that people have fought for before today. Today, we will stand up against this police, crime, sentencing and court bill. We kill this bill. These are the kind of things that will be affected by this bill. So please go to the Stand Up to Racism Facebook page for more details on that. It is the suffragettes and the chartists protesting for the right to vote and working conditions, the right for their voice to be heard. We have continued to fight for working conditions, wages, fuel prices, poverty, war, human rights, immigration, both for and against, refugees, black and ethnic minority rights, discrimination, police brutality, fathers' rights, LGBTQ rights, and climate change. The list goes on. This particular issue, the bill to take away our right to peaceful protest, unites us all in the same plight. Our freedom and the freedom of future generations. Even those who have never supported a cause before, maybe you've never been marginalised, maybe you've never put yourself in someone else's shoes, now is the time to be the activist, every single one of us, to make changes for anything you may want to see in the future. Your grandchildren have a word to give. Forever hold your peace.
slowly stitching lips silenced by a suppressed society, muting complaints of fascism, freedom and futures with fear of fine and persecution.
Repressed, restrained and restricted, removing democratic human rights.
In plain sight, we must fight. Left with little alternative, thanks to the Conservatives. Rethink, reskill, rebuild. Regress, recede, retreat. Bound and gagged by a bill in amount of inconvenience. Protect your right to protest or forever hold your peace.
Quite humbled by. She does so much amazing work for exiled families. She's got another amazing Shiro who is an activist in every way. And I think this is what the media wanted, for BLM and exile not to work together, to make us and pit us against each other. It takes me so much pleasure to introduce Lizzie from Exile Family.
Right now to build a positive future. We will start today.